Hello, Jim here. Thanks for joining the Discovery Divers channel, the channel that aims to be informative and yes, sometimes even entertaining. Today what I've got is a culmination of the Scuba Gases Week that I've conducted here. And today features an incident for analysis, a Scuba Nitrox incident. All right, I think there's a lot to learn from analysis of incidents. Personally, I like to do that with all of my activities, including motorcycling, or I like to watch other people almost getting in trouble with motorcycles, and then it helps me be safer. And scuba is the same thing. So with my Nitrox course, after my lecture, I would have this incident I got from Scuba Board almost 20 years ago. And I would have my students in small groups kind of pick apart what it is we could learn about Nitrox from this incident. And nobody was seriously injured, so it's doubly a good incident to have a look at. So if you'd like to cut your teeth and give it a try, here's what I recommend. Today, I'm going to put and describe the incident for analysis, and then I'm gonna leave it until next weekend. Please go ahead, post up in the comments what you think the factors are that are at play here and your analysis of what's going on. So what are the things that were done wrong here? How could they have been prevented? What kind of incident is this actually? Let's get into it. I was diving a shipwreck called the Tracy in about 75 feet or 23 meters of water off the coast of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I had two diving buddies. When we reached the wreck, conditions were good, though not great. 40 feet or 12 meters of visibility and a light current. I was on 36% Nitrox, which was checked at the shop. Upon reaching the wreck, I began to experience a shortness of what seemed to be oxygen in the mix. I felt a lack of oxygen. I was getting all the volume I demanded for my regulator, ScubaPro S600, yet felt like it was not oxygen. Confused, I swam towards one of my buddies, which turned into a dash due to the increased deficiency of oxygen. Despite the standard signals I gave him for difficulty breathing, all I got was a spaced out look from him, oblivious to what was unfolding right in front of his eyes. At this point, I pointed straight up with my hand and bolted in a semi-controlled panic. I knew that something was deadly wrong. I knew I needed to breathe and I needed to reach the surface. I also knew that my chances for survival would be in my favor, risking the bends or embolism to reach the surface. I was literally suffocating. At about 30 feet or 9 meters from the surface, I suddenly started to feel like the oxygen was returning and quickly returned to normal. I went back down to find the two individuals diving with me to let them know I was okay and to do a proper ascent for off-gassing. When the problem occurred, it seemed like I was sucking on pure nitrogen. Can the gases separate or layer off in the tanks? I know for a fact that the shop owner does not roll tanks to get proper mix, as did the previous owner. Any suggestions, recommendations are deeply appreciated. Okay, that's the incident. So please go ahead, have a think, put your comments below, and I will look at your comments, but I have my standard analysis of this incident, but I'll also have a look at your comments, and I will post up what I have next week in the response video. All right? Okay, looking forward to what you come up with. Thanks a lot, and see you next week.